Listen to me. That's why we can't serve God with an open heart. We are not honest in our worship because no separation has taken place. Before the Holy Spirit can enter in you, the son of your mother must go to sleep. The son of God must arise. What am I talking about? When the Holy Spirit enter in you, the DNA of your forefathers, of your mother, will die. The DNA of Jesus, of God, will arise. The Bible says there was a time when Jesus was busy teaching. They came and said, Lord, your mother and your brothers are calling you. The Bible says, Jesus said, who is my mother? Who is my father? Who are my brothers? My brothers are those who concern themselves with the things of God. What does it mean? It means Jesus, the son of Joseph, the son of Mary, was asleep. Jesus, the son of God, was alive. We serve God through the Holy Spirit. Whatever that we try to do for God, if it's not through Jesus, in the power of the Holy Ghost, it is sin. That's why the prayers of many people are not answered, because they pray with the person of the son and the daughter of their mothers, not with the person of the Holy Ghost. There was a separation that took place in the apostles before the Holy Spirit came upon them. Their belief in Jesus was questionable, including Peter. Peter is the very man that made a promise to Jesus that, Lord, wherever you go, I will follow you even unto death. Jesus said, verily I tell you, truthfully I tell you, that before it crows three times, before it crows, you will deny me three times. That's what Jesus said. Because Jesus knew that the statement of Peter was too human to walk in the mystery well. But now, after there was a separation, after there was a divorce between Peter, the son of a human being, and Peter, the son of God, there was no truth that will come out of his mouth. But they took a separation. Listen to this. Before there was a separation, before there was an encounter between Peter and the Holy Spirit, he denied Jesus because he was fearful. After there was a separation, he's the very same Peter that stood in front of officials, judges, and the high priest and said, I will choose to testify in the name of the Lord. Do what you want to do. Because it was not Peter talking, but it was the power of the Holy Ghost. Whatever we try to do in serving God, if the Holy Spirit does not indwell us, we are playing. That's why we find it difficult to practice the scripture, to practice the way. What we speak and what we do are completely two different things. Because we are too human. The son of your mother, the daughter of your mother, have not yet died. That's why you can follow Jesus. Paul the apostle said, it is no longer I who lives, but Christ in me. Because when he made an encounter with Jesus on his way to Damascus, the son of man in Paul died, and the son of God was born. Paul the apostle, before he met Jesus in the power of the Holy Spirit, he could kill, he could destroy, he could persecute saints, innocent people, because the son of his mother was still alive. But the Bible says he met a lightning and he became blind. The son of man inside Paul took a nap. The son of God arose. The murderer, a sinner, was put to sleep so that the Holy Spirit may function. The Holy Spirit find it difficult to operate in us, to move in us, because we are still alive. There is a hindrance between your walk with God. That's why you can never know Jesus in person, because you are still alive. Your flesh, the son of your mother, the daughter of your mother, is still too alive for you to meet the son of God. You are limited in everything you say, because you don't know him in person. To walk with God in a mysterious manner, we need to be assisted by the Holy Ghost. For your prayer to be heard in heaven above, you need to be assisted by the Holy Ghost. The Bible says, after the Spirit of power rested upon them, they began to speak in tongues and languages they didn't know, but they just spoke as the Spirit gave them utterance. It means when the Holy Spirit rests on you, you speak mysteries that men cannot understand, but they are valid, because it's not you talking. They began to prophesy. They began to see things in the spirit realm. They foretold mysteries that came to pass because the Holy Ghost was with them, was within them, was around them. And the sons of their mothers have been slaughtered, put to sleep. The Bible says, wherever the apostles, the disciples of Jesus, entered, they turned the cities upside down because they were not alone. The Spirit of God was with them. They were on the earth, but their walk was a mysterious one, unknown unto men. The Bible says they could walk through walls. Prisons could not contain them, because they had another person residing in them called the Holy Ghost. Prisons could not contain them. Pain could not limit them. Fear of the government could not silence them, because there was another power that was talking. unknown to man, not even death could stop them. Paul says in the book of Romans chapter 8, what can separate us from the love of God? Is it death? Is it height? Is it famine? Nothing can separate us, because it was Christ within him. Paul of Tarsus had been put to sleep. This was Paul, the apostle. Remember, he was Saul before, until he met the Holy Spirit. Then the name was changed. Paul. The literal meaning of the word Paul means small. Before Paul could meet the light of Christ, could meet the Holy Spirit, he was Saul, a prosecutor, a mighty warrior, a giant, a man who brings fear upon the people. He was big, but when he met the Holy Spirit, he was reduced. To less than nothing. But God showed his power through nothing. He received the name Paul, which means small. For us to walk with God, we need to be reduced to nothing, to something small, to manifest the great power and strength of God. That's why the Bible says, my strength is made perfect in your weakness. You know why God cannot use us? Because we are too big. We are too strong. We are too independent. We are too wise. That's why Jesus cannot use us, because we will take the glory. When we meet the Holy Spirit, he humbles us so that God may be God. It doesn't matter how much we can be blessed. When we meet Jesus, we become humble. We don't see ourselves anymore. We lose the sight of mankind. We receive the sight of God. It's all about God. Your problem, you don't want to be made small by God. Some of you want to share glory with Jesus. When God give you a job that you didn't have, when God give you children that you didn't have, when God give you marriage that you didn't have, you start to see yourself. It's all about yourself. You make your neighbors to feel like nothing, because you believe you have it all, because we have not met the Holy Spirit. People who have the Holy Spirit, they can have more than enough, but you will never see, because they are too small. They are hiding behind God. The Bible says, when Moses was in the mountain and he said to God, I want to see you, I want to know you as I'm known, God said to him, there is a recipe for you to know me, for you to see me. No man can see me and be alive. For you to see me, you need to die. God said, there is a rock close by. There is a rock close to me. For you to see me, you need to go and hide behind the rock. You need to be small, that the rock may cover you. Then you will see me. He had to hide and become a small boy. A mighty prince of Egypt, the mighty prophet, had to hide to see God. People who are too big, they never get reduced to smallness. They hate to be little. They want to be known by everyone that I am able. I've got a nice car. I've got a big house. I have a nice job. I am doing well. Everyone in Sunrise must know about me. You will never know God. God wants people that will be reduced to a state of littleness to know him. When you are reduced to nothing, the strength of God will be made manifest, will be made perfect. The Bible says David was the youngest in his family. The Bible says he was handsome, short, and he looked weak in the body. But God saw a giant, because the strength of David was not in his stature. The strength of David was in the God that was above him, was in the Lord of heaven, the armies, was resting in the God of the armies of Israel. That is the reason why when David had to fight Goliath, he didn't look at his muscles, he didn't look at his experience, but he looked at his God. How great are you, Lord, Lord of heavenly armies? How mindful are you of the sons of men? He didn't look at himself to qualify to fight Goliath.
Narekele, narekele mo. Lift your hands.
What shall I do?